Hey, you're listening to the 5 for 5 show from Boombox Music Talk.
That is why we do this podcast, is music is the ultimate thing that brings everybody together, because everybody
it's
understands.
The ultimate super glue.
So tune in when we get in there, let's do a really good job, okay? So that really needs to be said. Well, not everything the guy says needs to be said. Sometimes it's just about the music of a conversation.
Welcome to another episode of Boombox Music Talk, our podcast celebrating the relative perspective of music and all things audio. All right, I'm really excited actually about today's topic for this 5 for 5 is actually what we are doing today. I have my almost always with me, sometimes never absent, Richie Sambora, it's my Bon Jovi. Miss Krish.
What's up, guys? How's it going?
Miss Christmas, Merry Christmas.
It's a Christmas miracle.
Today. Yeah, it is a Christmas miracle. So we are going to do top five. We'll get straight into it. Top five of our favorite office musical moments. We are huge fans of the show The Office.
I'm really excited about this, by the way.
I am too.
I've been looking forward to this one for quite some time.
Yes.
Yeah.
To say huge fans is kind of an understatement, considering that if you walk into the betting house,
because it's plural.
The betting high, which is betting high.
Yeah.
I'm betting high on this. You will almost always, sometimes never find it absent, playing from the TVs.
Mm-hmm. Streaming from the TVs.
Streaming sounds, it even sounds gratuitous.
Mm-hmm, it does, like, totally does.
Like too much.
No more s'mores. No more s'mores.
I'm going to stream you so hard.
I'm going to stream it so hard.
Yep.
I'm going to stream it night.
Actually,
and day.
I watch it or listen to it every single day at lunch. That is like my calming moment. I'm going to stream you so hard.
I'm going to stream it so hard.
Yep. Got your sausage.
Actually, actually, I watch it yummy, or yummy. Listen Thank to you. It every single day Lion. At lunch. That is like my calming.
What was the thing you needed me
moment.
To come in early for? The sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit. But thank you. And why don't you just take a couple hours? Office is yours. Home alone, risky business. Take your pants off, run around. Whatever you ought to do.
I'm just gonna take a nap in my car till work starts.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just listening to, what is it? The foibles of the office
yeah.
personnel.
The foibles.
I love foibles.
You can't say foibles and stay mad.
No, you cannot say foibles.
You can't be like in the middle of an argument and be like, God damn it, I told you that if you didn't quit doing those stupid foibles. wait, no. Can't be mad now. Argument's over. You said foibles. I'm going to remember that.
Yep.
Next
oh,
time,
me too.
Next time we get into argument.
Or next time your boss is like, rawr, and then you can be like, foibles.
foibles.
It's like the parlay.
What kind of foibles are you talking about, boss? See if he stays mad.
That's going to make their brain
she
go,
stays mad.
Scoot. Mm-hmm.
Is scoot the same as skirt?
Scooting up the skirt is not.
Okay.
Elbows out.
Wish I could, but I can't. Well, can, but won't.
Should, maybe, but short.
Michael, please.
What part of short don't you understand?
But if you skirt.
If you skirt and then you scoot, I mean.
You might need to check your panties.
Because you got some skids.
I was skirting and scooting all over that place. I gotta take a bath.
That's what she said.
Anyway, back to the office. Yes, it's playing all the time when we sleep, when we're awake. Probably at an unhealthy
level,
I would imagine. Most people would be like, what? Seriously? Like, if they knew. If they
it's
really
not an
knew.
Obsession, though. No. Because it's not like we go seeking stuff out that's like office, you know, or the office. It's just that it's been a very calming experience. And if I had to choose out of shows, a handful of shows for the most calm one that I'm going to sleep to, it's going to be that one.
Yeah.
Not a lot of music going on or craziness occasionally, but not
evidently,
a lot.
Sometimes there's music. Because that's what we're talking about today.
It is, it is.
I saw a friend today, it had been a while. And we forgot each other's names. But it didn't matter, cause deep inside, the feeling still remained the same.
But I will say, I was surprised at how difficult it was, because I literally went through almost every episode and tried to find every song then, you know, so I could pick out my
There's a lot more than you think there is.
There's a lot more than you think there is.
For such a calming, chill show.
Yeah. However, if you make a comparison from The Office to another show, the amount of music in The Office is very little.
That's true.
You know, like,
the fact that they point out episodes with music, like people on the web will talk about it. The fact that that's a thing means that there's not really a lot of other music.
Yeah,
where other shows have background music and stuff.
A lot of background music. Silence. Yep, which is what makes it so calming to sleep to for me, because if I hear music, then I want to move or I want to listen to the lyrics. Like, my brain is not going to calm down.
Yeah, no, that's true.
Yeah, it gets real active and alpha wavy.
Yep. But just the people, I mean, the characters are so ridiculously just well-rounded without really having to do a lot. I mean, the main characters, obviously, but it's just, they're all so calming and...
And they did a good job, too, of incorporating, like, some of their own personalities, you know, or aspects, not their whole personalities, but some aspects of their personalities.
I wonder how they sat around. I wonder if each day if they sat, you know, they're looking in front of the mirror and they're like, all right, today I'm going to be myself a little bit more in this.
I imagine they do. I do that.
Is that a conscious decision?
I imagine they're like normal people that sometimes.
Yeah, I know. Me too. I'm like, today you're going to go and you're going to talk to 3 people. I know it's a lot. But just have 3 conversations.
That is pretty ambitious, because I usually just, like, today you're going to talk to somebody. But
say hi to another human.
You're going to acknowledge another human's existence.
Yeah.
It's going to be hard, but you're going to get through it.
Yeah. Which is why I like doing this podcast, celebrating the relative perspective of things, because we waited for a little while before we did this to think about our moments. And when we came back, I was almost positive that we were going to have 80% of them
matching moments.
Matching. Yeah. Which, yes, I did do the math in my head just then. I was like, yes, I know math.
I know math.
I did that
ball
real quick in my head. I knew that there was 5. And so that's going to be 20 cents in dollar 5 times. Mm-hmm. That's how I got to that moment. So, but actually, we only had one that was the same. So, I'm looking forward to kind of hearing your reasoning on some of this.
Me too.
So we're gonna jump right into it today. Do you want to start? Or do you want me to start?
So who talks first? You talk first. I talk first.
Sure. I'll start.
All right. What's your number 5?
All right. So wait, would that be best or worst?
No.
In your scale.
Well, not worst, but.
Every time somebody recommends a doctor, he's always the best. Always, is he good? Oh, he's the best. This guy's the best. They can't all be the best. There can't be this many best. Someone's graduating at the bottom of these classes. Where are these doctors? Is somewhere someone saying to their friend, you should see my doctor. He's the worst. Oh, yeah, he's the worst. He's the absolute worst there is.
Or not
it's
worst.
It's the worst of the five you chose, which is a weird way to celebrate something. You're the worst third winner. You mean I got third place? Yes. From least to goodest.
From least?
What's worst? We can't tell you if it's going to be better or worse. We can just say...
Go home and step on a scale and write down how much you weigh and subtract it by like 20. And then weigh that much.
So your top moment should be last.
Okay. Top moment.
I promise
should be
we've
last.
Tried. We plan these shows out ahead of time.
We do. We talk like at it, great length about them.
We usually just talk around them, and then we're like, "Yeah, we're ready to go." And then we get there and we realize, "Oh, we talked about everything except for actually doing the show."
Yeah.